Hotel Infinity, Part 4. Recap. You run a hotel with an infinite number of rooms. When the rooms are full, you can make space for new guests by rearranging your current occupants. You can even make room for a sports team with an infinite number of players. But one night, an infinite number of infinite teams show up at once. Is it possible to accommodate them? Well, it is possible, as it turns out, and here's how. First, have the players in each team line up in order next to their bus. Player 1, player 2, and so on. Have the buses drive away, giving you room to work. The players are neatly arranged in an infinite number of infinitely long lines, and if you can somehow arrange them into a single infinite line, then you're set. And you can do exactly that by cordoning the yard off into zigzagging diagonal rows. The player in the first row goes first, then the 2 players in the second row, then the 3 players in the third. Every single player has a place in this new zigzagging line. You clear out the odd-numbered rooms for them, and there's space for all once more. Their stay goes swimmingly, and before they check out, the coach approaches you again. "You know," she says, "I'm training a highly competitive meditation team on my homeworld, and I'd love to bring them by the next time we're in the neighborhood, but I've had some reservations. See, they use a very non-traditional numbering system for their jerseys. They're numbered by the positive rational numbers. There's a player 1/2, a player 5/9, a player 7, a player 78/11. For every positive integer and every positive fraction, there's a player who wears that number. I'd love to bring them here, but I always figured you might not have room for them. But now I'm thinking you just might be able to accommodate them after all," she says with a grin. "We can," you say. "We could arrange them in the parking lot in an infinite number of infinite rows. First all the integers, then all the multiples of 1/2, then all the multiples of 1/3, and so on. Then use the same tactic as before to arrange them in a single line, and it's done. There is room for everyone at Hotel Infinity." You and the coach share a celebratory high five. But as the echo fades, you notice a new light in the sky. A light that's growing brighter. You turn and look, just in time to see a gleaming ship hurtle out of the sky and then slow itself, landing gently by your door. A hatch opens, revealing the President of Space, her eyes fixed on you, urgently. "Just the person I was hoping to find," she says. "We need your help." A figure appears beside her, wearing a lab coat and smiling giddily. "This is my Chief Science Officer of Science," she explains. "He has made an alarming discovery." "Highly alarming," he agrees. "My team has found a portal to another universe. It's full of wonders, rocks we've never seen before, bugs we've never seen before." "And people," says the President. "A group of people like we've never seen before. They traveled here through the portal, and now they need a place to stay." A shape appears behind her, a shifting, gooey mass, like a cookie cut out of a slab of jello. "And here they are," says the President. "All of them." "All of them?" you ask. "I only see one." "They're two-dimensional," says the scientist. "They're flat like paper, stacked together like a deck of cards." The shape moves, and a mouth opens. Many mouths, actually, belonging to more creatures than you can count, all clumped together like cards in a deck. "Hello," the creatures intone in unison. "We are many, and all are pleased to meet you. Do you have shelter for us, for our stay in your vast, strange world?" "Pleased to meet you as well," you offer. "May I ask your names?" The creature closest to you answers first. "I'm called Zero." The creature at the back speaks up as well, saying, "My name is One." A voice pipes up from the middle of the stack, saying, "I'm called 1/2. And a chorus of occasional voices speaks up from within the mass of people, calling out numbers. "Some of our names can't be spoken in this world," says Zero. "Or at least not finished until your universe turns homogeneous and cold. But we're all named after numbers. 0 and 1, and all the numbers in between. We're standing in order before you. Lower numbers in front, higher numbers in back. No number is missing. All are here, from 0 all the way to 1. "So," asks Zero, "do you have room for us? One room for each of us to call our own during our stay?" The President looks at you, as does the scientist, and the coach, and the visitors from another world, 0 all the way to 1. But you're not sure what to tell them. Do you have room or not? In the next and final installment, we'll answer this question, but try to figure it out on your own. Let us know if you think of a way of doing it, or a reason why it can't be done. Until next time in Hotel Infinity.